third time. Here we go again. I got to skip Dave's introduction. Nah, I'm alright. Yes, Tappy talked. What the? But, I'm gonna do the good ending first this time, which is weird, because usually I go bad guy, but I'm gonna go good guy.
Why, hello there, future entrepreneur. Congratulations on purchasing the start-your-own Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria location kit, 1993 edition.
No problem.
I am your friendly company representative.
You look terrifying.
I am not a child murderer.
I don't believe you.
Freddy's is a chain of fast food joints that span the entire of America. At its prime, Freddy's had over 50 active locations, most of which were permanently shut down due to a suspicious number of toddlers going missing on our premises. How crazy is that? I'm sure glad that I've had nothing to do with any of that. You, good sir, are a young visionary who bought the Freddy's merchandising kit for a hefty fee of $12.50. The first step of setting up a successful Freddy's Pizza joint is to choose a suitable location. And not just any cardboard box will do. Small enough that mysterious giant scugglers can't lay eggs in your restaurant undetected. Trust me on that one. Secondly, you need at least two rooms. A room for dancing in, and a room for bleeding out in. Don't splurge on buying a location. Also, save yourself a headache and avoid carpet. You'll thank me later. Next, you need ingredients for your pizza. The nearest dumpster will do nicely. You want your pizza to have that distinctive Freddy's taste, don't you? Next, you'll need performers. Robots are expensive. So just buy a fat dog over 20 bucks and call it a fucking day. Or, better yet, fish something out of the trash. Don't attempt to murder any kids that are buffer than you are. Don't put the rabbit's face on a goddamn pizza. Taxation is theft. Don't pay taxes. Don't drop kick any screaming toddlers. And don't the facts during business hours. That's all I have for this 8. Goodbye, future restaurant owner. And remember, you are the new face to Freddy Fazbear's pepperoni.
It's a little bear deity and all this shirt. Oh, it's one of those shirts. Okay.
Why, hello there, future business owner. Welcome to your new Freddy's location. Like all Freddy's locations, it's probably a complete dump.
Yeah.
But, rest assured, with enough business savvy antics, you'll be able to afford running water in no time. Your Freddy's issue camera panel should now be sent to your restaurant's current layout. Depressing, isn't it?
Yep.
Most beginning Freddy's locations have at least two rooms, a dining area, and a safe room. This is your dining area.
Whoa!
If you were lucky, you had enough money left over after buying a place to afford tables. What? What kind of lucky fellow would choose to start up at Freddy's location, eh? Don't worry, with time, you can upgrade everything, from the floors, to the walls, to the moss on the walls.
Let's go to the moss!
Dream big, think of better moss.
Amen.
This is your safe room. It's an off-camera room where employees can smoke, complain about you without getting fired, and put on horrendous mascot costumes. Spring suits are hard to come by these days. So, you're probably gonna be serving birthday cake in a bear onesie for a while.
Yeah. Joke's on you, Dave. I just stuck Golden Heady into an existing spring lock body.
Fret not so, entrepreneur. soon enough, you can buy death traps, and then hire young adults in older ages to die them. Creepy. Now, let's draw paperwork.
Alright.
Sign all of it right now. Go put it in it, and sign it all later, at your leisure. Now, first things first. You have a fuck ton of big red letters at your disposal. What name are you gonna slap onto your restaurant?
Choose a name restaurant. Freddy Fazbender's Pizza, Freddy's House of Pleasure, Freddo's Vile Pepperonary, Uncle Jack's Family Diner, or Bear. I feel like it's obvious what we gotta choose.
Good choice, I'm guessing. Now, we also included several cut-out Freddy's heads to go above the name of your pizza. Your corporate didn't want me to throw in this Fredbear cutout, since we accidentally took it mid-chunk while he had a kid in his mouth. But since I'm the only one here now, I put Fredbear's head in the damn pile. So, choose wisely.
Fredbear mid-chunk.
You just made the partially irrelevant choice. With all of that out of the way, it's time to go outside, put up your tacky bare head, and call this place open. Goodbye, and remember, you are the face of Freddy Fazbender's Pepperoni.
Thanks, Dave. Maniac revives bear-worshipping pizza cult. This is simply the worst possible timeline. Concerned local parents. Da 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 da. Good music though. Bum 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 bum. Children. Amazing! Actual customers have shown up. Good God, if you play your cards right, you'll be able to buy a table next month. Get suited up and bring birthday cake to the kids. You stole a wedding cake 3 months ago. Cakes are too magical to go stale, right? Oh, man. That's good. If any kids get food poisoning, just respond to their parents with that. It's cake time. That's why I hate kids. No.
That's not the 6 p.m. I remembered.
Golden Heady.
Hello, this is the Los Angeles Police Department.
I'm innocent?
Am I speaking to the owner of Bear?
Bear? Nope, sounds like you got the wrong
guy. We googled your restaurant's phone number. We called the number that came up.
Alright, you got me. What do you
this
want?
This is an incredibly serious matter. We require that you cooperate.
We'll see about that.
May we ask for your name, sir?
It's better... You know what? Does this character have an actual name? Like a real life, like a real name? Time to look it up on the web. Orange Man from name. His name is Jack. All right then. That is his name.
Jack, is it? You sound like a Jack. All right.
What's that mean? Oh, his last name's Kennedy? The more you know.
We need to ask you another question.
Just playing Metal Gear.
Have you heard anything about what happened outside your restaurant today?
Have you heard anything about my restaurant today? No, what happened?
Basically, a child named Jacob Adams got abducted outside the new Freddy's location at around 5 p.m.
And that's my problem?
No witnesses were close enough to fully make out what happened.
Even better.
And the reports that we've gotten so far are totally outlandish and paranormal. We know that you were inside when it happened, and we're just calling all nearby businesses out of courtesy. Please, be vigilant.
Yes ma'am. I'm
Something is outside your restaurant, and it has already taken one child away. Make sure to lock up tight, and to keep a close eye out.
Sure do. Thanks, officer.
Good night, Jack.
Hi, buddy.
What the heck? He looks majestic. Save your game? Sure. Oh, that's a lot of files. How many is that? 100? I guess we'll have to figure out which file I saved on.
Why, hello there, future restaurant owner.
Hola.
Look, I'm gonna level with you. I don't know what you're gonna hear these texts in, but all I know, Afton Robotics has closed its doors, and no new robots are being made. What? All of that aside, why would you want to spend money on brand new robots when you're just gonna get children's blood and buffalo wing sauce all over them a month after purchase? What you should do is cut corners. Cutting corners at the cost of customer safety. Why, that's the American dream.
True.
So, here's what you need to do. Grab a phone book and look for the nearest abandoned Freddy's location. Most of them are abandoned. As of me recording this, so unless they are bulldozed or burnt down, you've got easy pickings. Go to whatever location you can get to, find your way inside, and then take the most complete robot you can. Shine, those old things might be dangerous, but what? You'll save a fortune. And besides, customers love those fucking things. Nothing beats 80s nostalgia. Worry not. Future restaurant owner. If anything goes wrong, you can always just relocate and change your name, right? After all, what kind of man buys a Freddy's location and uses their real name?
True.
Anyway, that's it for this tape. Goodbye, and remember, you are the funky face of Freddy Fazbender's pepperoni.
Boy, it sure is dark in here. Well, time to get searching. I'm sure I'll find more here than I did last time. What'd you have to do? Is this the... second loop? Is this day shift the phrase 2 location? Because that's what it looks like, because it's got that slide. Ugh, I hate it. What'd you like to do? Screw you, balloon boy. Spring Freddy. Wow. I think... And I think you want to sing for one thing, then. Strangely enough, it seems to be out of repair since you last seen it. Oh my god, I know this song. Why? Salvaging. To commit a salvage. Yes. Search the self. Do we go south last time? I'm pretty sure we went north last time. A pile of rubble. Has someone been here since I last told him? What would you like to do? Search west, I guess. We got one death suit, might as well find another. We gotta bring Toy Freddy back. We have to. Do. Inspect Toy Freddy. He's missing a leg and an eye. Salvage him. So I take Toy Freddy back with you. Yeah, I can't just leave my man Toy Freddy back there, you know? What would you like to do? East. East was the way I went last time. West? Where did I go last time? So, these three, I'm pretty sure it's east the way I just went. Did I accidentally click on north? Okay, yeah, so now I actually have to go north then. Because north's the way I didn't go. East is the first way I went then. Enter the room behind the stage. Withered Freddo. Inspect Withered Freddo. Boy. Pretty sure he's seen better days. Salvage him. Yes. Oh, wait, instead of Toy Freddy? Oh, No. We need to bring Toy Freddy. We have to. That's a requirement. Guess we're leaving Withered Freddy and, the demon child behind. Oh, wait, I forgot. Which one was Toy Freddy? Was he the north? Not north. West, please. Be right. Yeah! What is that thing behind you? Oh, it's a slide. Check with Freddy. Salvage him. Yes. Alright, time to get out of this place fast. Oh, we're only allowed
not take one thing with us? Yeah, we have to take Dwarf Freddy. Got what I came for. Time to go. Very well. It is done. Say goodbye to Third Man. Tomorrow is another day. Denver! You have one thing left to do tonight. Go to your workshop. Oh, yeah, I can still click. Click. Is this the sound of silence? Oh my god, it is. This game never amazes me with its amazingness. Sure. Yeah, that's a word. That's not ominous. She's up and running. It is time. Almost dropped something. This is your last chance to find their souls. Your last chance at redemption. Your last chance to give those souls those happy day. Yay! You have to go inside. Hostile place. Save often. Press X / escape. What file did I save on? Not save my game. All right. No. Dave?
Oh, sport. Is that you?
Dave! Dave!
You know, old sport, I never thought I'd see you here. Since you saw this end, all.
What is this place? Where am I? And what's that supposed to mean?
This is a place where souls hang out. And well, you know.
Okay, fine. Now where am I?
Okay, time to spill the beans.
Where the heck am I, man?
Right now, we're standing in the realm known as the flip side. Ooh. It's a place where dreams come to die, and lost souls eat pizza and stuff.
So this is an office job?
Basically, you've left your timeline and come to a place outside of your own reality. The flip side.
The flip side.
the flip side.
The flip
as
side?
As it is currently known, is a place where lost souls retreat to.
You that's did. Impossible.
You did the damn fax about 12 times while it was haunted.
Ha!
Please tell me that you didn't actually think that a sentient child's mind was inside that fax while you were doing the do.
No.
The flip side allows souls to remain intact, even if a soul's vessel commits an atrocity in the name of vengeance.
Alright.
Okay. Stuff a night guards into suits. Buy another kids. Be in call for a brother blue testicle by workers. That's too much for a child's mind to bear. Over time, souls tend to retreat to the flip side. And as a result, their vessels become more bearable. Which is why I'm here.
Good question, why are you here?
I've been here for years, to be honest. Or, some form of me has, at least, years or whatever vice, sportsy. Never try to put a soul back into a corpse. Especially not over and over again.
Whatever. So I have my soul back, I'll keep that in mind.
For the longest time, I always wondered, why don't all ghosts do this? I know now. Years and years of clinging onto my own dead body has caused my soul to rot and tear itself apart. The more reasonable side of me has retreated here.
So, the side that doesn't kill kids for fun?
More or less.
Okay, what about the other part of your soul?
I have no clue where my feral side has got to do. It's still out there, I bet. It usually comes back. It always does.
He said the thing. Wait, are there any other alive people in... alive people here, aside from us?
No, other than us, there's only stray souls in me around here. But then again, I'm not exactly sure if I'm what you'd call alive, and we ain't neither. Actually, that's exactly why you're able to move between the flip side and reality.
What do you mean?
The flip side is a place for souls to physically move around. If a normal human ever tried to enter here, through the glass of that arcade machine, their own soul would push back against the glass. Like a reflection on the other end of a mirror. Without a soul, nothing can push you back through the glass. You can come and go as you please. Interesting.
Okay.
I haven't really kept up to date on what's going on in reality. I last checked that around the early 90s. Granted, I could easily take a gander at what reality they've seen.
That's useful.
You know, it's actually quite fortunate that you decided to come here tonight. Something eerie has happened.
Oh?
Do you remember the real Fred Bear?
Yeah. Of course I do. I swore promise to that very bear.
Good, good. Anyway, he went fucking AWOL.
Pardon?
Well, being a non-literal entity, he spent quite a lot of time here, with the lost souls, watching reality, waiting for the right time to jump in it. What? He hasn't been seen here in quite a while. He left one day, and never returned. I don't know what exactly went down in reality. What? Something bad clearly happened to the Fred Bear.
Oh. My bad. Hey.
This place has been extra screwed up since then.
Yeah, what a crazy thing. I don't know anything about it, really. I see perhaps I should get going here.
Say, if you're going, perhaps I could join you. I could use a friend here.
Maybe I could be that friend.
I'd like that, sportsy. I'd like that a hell of a lot. Think about it. You have some kind of quest to go on. I'm bored enough to do whatever painful task you set me to. It's a win-win situation. Besides, there's robots afoot. You're gonna want me around to help fight them off, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Come on, Dave. Show me around this godforsaken place.
Oh, this is gonna be so much fun. It'll be like a slumber party, except we're fighting 7-foot tall animal robots and searching for dead people.
Thanks, Dave. Let's explore, Dave.
You even see a robot effortlessly pick up and fly an entire table while chasing a night guard. I remember old Daniel O'Hanlon, always drunk on a job. That bastard. Anyway, Bonnie funked a table on him and crushed him flat. Made him rip and funk. Yes. Most of the games that Freddy said was shit, to be frank, other than Bread Bear and Facts Media, utter garbage.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, what is it?
Can I pay you to stop talking about the Foxy Street?
Consider it done. Fred Bear. You know, after the company bought the Fred Bear character from us in 1983, I decided to invent this little fella as a way to antagonize them. My own C. Even snuck these cabinets into their arcades. Bonnie never figured out how to deactivate them. So he just put passive-aggressive messages into the game. Good times. Utter garbage.
Thanks, Ned.
I swear, I see this cabinet in every location I work at. Why does it look like that? Actually, on second thought, I see it in every location you work at.
Yeah, I've noticed it too.
Strange. Let's keep moving.
What? What? Fine, let's go, Freddy.
You even see a robot, Dave?
Yes. Yes, I have. Or, no, I haven't, but I've heard you tell me about it.
There's the bear himself. I swear, Freddy's only invented him so they could have a bear that could compete with our Fred Bear. Recoloring him banana yellow and calling him Golden Freddy was a massive fuck you to Henry after we refused to sell the Fred Bear character.
Pizza. Chicken. Chicken. Chicken.
Okay, I just remember I left my lunch bags in the supply closet. At some point, we should make our way over to the supply closet.
And where would that be?
Let's just keep moving to the right. And hope we'll eventually hit it.
Okay, right there. Bonnie. Oh, explore the flip side with Dave. We're being attacked! Alright, time to attack! Killed a man. Woo! No? Okay. Let's go this way. We just- Oh god, there's two of them. We're about to die. Oh yeah, we're done. Oh god. Yep, run. Well, we almost just got murked. It's a chicken! Yeah! Why won't it hit? I refuse to give up on Dave. Boom, 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 boom. Please tamper. Why won't it work? God, that's a lot of damage. Take that, chicken. Oh, I ate you for KFC one time. Not again! Not again. Too much genocide on chicken. Let's go! Alright, I say we should- I like to make the executive decision to save. Dave! War machine. No dialogue, Dave. Alright, see how it is. Was this all for naught? It was.
Yeah. yet they really tried to erase Fred Bear from the company after the bite of 83. Covered up every damn poster they had up. Serves them right, I think, for purchasing such an accursed character in the first place.
Yeah. Let's head down. Actually, no. Oh, doesn't matter. Oh, yeah, bear? Escaped. I forgot what Slippery did. Since we're not going into the closet yet, because we want more Dave dialogue. No, this isn't the closet.
Utter garbage. Fred Bear. Utter garbage.
Ready?
Bread Bear.
Yeah! This is a certified Bread Bear moment. Ignore that, because that's where we're supposed to go, and I want to hear Dave.
There's the bear himself.
Oh, come on! I mean, hey, speaking of bears. Yeah, it's once in a while. Alright, dual act. It's all thanks to Dave. Couldn't have done it without him.
Like your pizza.
Plain pepperoni cheese, no sauce. And I agree with all of that except the no sauce.
Yeah,
ever
think about having a little eggplant on your pizza?
Dave, you're purple. You realize that? Because that just sounds not right. You're forbidden from talking about pizza with me again. Honestly, fair choice.
Hey, Sportsy.
Forbidden.
Hey, Sportsy.
Nope. Forbidden. Dave should not have said anything about eggplants and pizza. No, how's... Oh, not again! Guarding while Dave tampers.
Women's restroom. Oh, no. How naughty.
Shut up, Dave.
I heard a company rumor that one of Just Freddy's stalls had a hold on Go killed them inside it. A fat dog with a waffle in its mouth sat on a John, wearing a crown, and basically ruled over time and space. Typical Freddy's rumor.
Foxy Grand Canyon. Please, no.
Look. Sportsy, it's the facts. Did I ever tell you about the time I...
Yeah, I know. Pick up the facts, pick up the fox. Grand Canyon.
You're no fun.
Oh, God. Please, no. Dang it! You were what I was trying to avoid, you stupid chicken! should have messed with Jack Squad. The power of Purple Guy and Orange Man prevails. We just like... There we go. Bruh! Alright. Paper, screw you, Chica. And the chicken down!
Lunchbags. Oh, that reminds me. What were you looking for again?
Looking for stray souls, Dave.
Oh, right, Dad.
Please tell me you have an idea on where to search.
Well, the security office is the most haunted room here by far. You can't walk past that room without some kind of spectacle trying to scoot or pickle your organs. We should go check the security, see if anything's foot.
Sounds like a plan, Dave.
Coolio, let's get moving.
A lot of damage. I don't think we have enough flex tape to fix that either. Why? I just killed someone!
Okay, it's office time. Sportsy.
Forgot to save. Nope, don't save.
Let's wait for 10 seconds or so. Maybe something paranormal will fade in.
Ha!
Then you have it, old sport. Something paranormal.
Wow. Sure is easy to find. Like, it didn't jump scare us or anything. Just sitting there now.
Hey, golden bear, go see.
Oh, I didn't mean to skip that.
Me.
Me. You. I remember your voice.
My voice. Oh, good lord. You're one of mine, aren't you?
Yours?
Well, yeah. Okay, fine. I may have snagged a few kids, but my pal Henry was even better at it than me.
So you admit it. And your friend, he also murders lost children.
No, that's not Henry.
Both of you both taking lives that weren't your own. Both
oh, boy, here we go.
Does tamper work on bosses? Does tamper... We're about to find out. Never mind. Zero, okay, so no.
I fully intend to do exactly that.
Tamper does not work on bosses. We just killed him!
Just start fighting us. You go sleep, golden testicle.
You have not defeated me. I swear I keep fighting until both of you. Enough. I'm no child that's a lie. I think. I'm about to say. That voice. That face. I know who you are. I saw you on the news.
You saw Sportsy on the news.
That would mean... No, that's impossible. Yes. He owns a Freddy's restaurant. I see how it is now. You clearly opened a Freddy's restaurant to lure kids there so your partner could kill them outside.
Oh, sport. Since when do you own your own Freddy's restaurant?
It's been a long weekend. Wait a second. Oh my god. Is your name Jacob? How do you know my name? Dave, this is a child. This child was killed outside my restaurant. Just before I entered the flip side. A police officer called me and told me about it after work.
Wait, that can't be right. That would mean...
Jacob? You need to stop fighting us. I will avenge my own life. I will avenge the lives of others. Oh no, of the others. Who are also stuck here. Jacob? Killing me won't solve anything. I had nothing to do with what happened to you. But I remember his voice. Jacob, please. You aren't a golden bear. You're just a kid. I mean, I feel like that's pretty obvious. You don't know what I've been through. What he did to me. Tell me what happened, Jacob. I'll try to make it better. I promise. Emotions? Question mark? Oh, sad music. Now you know what's going down. I was 6 years old. Oof. It was a cool June evening at around 5 p.m. I was on my way to meet my friends at the newly opened Freddy's location. Bear! I walked up to the doors of the restaurant and gazed at the yellow bear head staring down at me from above the doorway. Without warning, something slipped up behind me and pulled me into the alley, or an alley. It smelled like death. And clasped its hands around my throat. I struggled, but its crest-mined neck was ironclad. My body remained in the alley until I was found later. My spirit left my dead body, and I wandered around this cold, lost. I tried to speak to those who were walking around me, but nobody could see me. I tried to change my form so people could see me. I tried to change my form to match the bear on your sign. But I couldn't. I didn't have the energy. I faded away and ended up here. This room looks like a Freddy's restaurant, so I've heard. Not that I've ever gotten to see inside a real Freddy's restaurant. Just like the happiest day I never got. My happiest day. See? You're a child, Jacob. I've been here for what feels like an eternity. Time doesn't work correctly here. I can no longer clearly remember my parents' faces. I miss them. Jacob, they definitely miss you too. Don't you want to see them again? Don't you want to move on? Yes, I do. Then it's time to stop fighting us, Jacob. Stop fighting. Sleep. You. Well, this is sad. I'm so alone, Jack. Nobody else here remembers who they are. Or what it was like to be a real, alive kid. To be real looking. That's why I took this form of a ghostly yellow bear. I didn't want to end up like the others. A robot. Jacob. I'm sorry your childhood was cut tragically short. I'm sorry you never got to see your friends that day. But this is no place for a child. It's time to stop fighting. It's time to rest. Jack. Thank you. Well, that was weird.
So, that's what freeing a lost soul feels like. It feels kinda nice.
Yeah. Tis. Yep.
But he said, it raises some concerns.
Really, like what?
Well, about some of the stuff Henry told me. These kids are just like you, Willie. They don't have good homes or families like we do. Look at how happy they are here. Don't you want them to experience this forever?
Henry told you what?
Yeah, he did. Do you think he was kinda wrong?
That son of a... Dave. I can assure you, that little girl that he abducted at the diner, her name was Dee. She had a family. And that family loved her unconditionally. Maybe she had no parents, but sure, that's life. Her older brother looked after her. They would have died for her.
What are you saying?
Nothing. I'm sorry, I'm rambling. It's time to go. It's time for me to go. I have a restaurant to run.
I can't believe you didn't tell me about that. Did you buy the start your own Freddy's kit? 1990.
I bought it secondhand. Found it at a flea market.
I see. Did they say that your restaurant was named Bear? That's bizarre. Like, just the word Bear. You have issues, Sportsy. out of curiosity, whose head that rested upon his side.
Fred Bears?
Good choice. That one's my favorite.
Yeah!
Everyone was long gone by the time I was making the kiddo, so I threw it in without permission. Company scandals be damned. I love that chompy funk.
Nom nom.
Henry really knew how to design a deadly long jaw. Oh, by the way, I'm just warning ya. Those tapes get a little strange later on. I might have lost my mind while recording those.
That sounds like something you would do. You mean more than you already had?
I should probably add, that kid said he recognized my voice. I'd be a little more concerned if I were you.
Trust me, I am.
No, you don't get it. The reasonable part of my soul is here. What? The feral side is still. If that kid recognized my voice, Reality Dave is still lurking around. And if he found your pizza place, he's probably trying to find you.
I'll keep an eye out.
Good, good. So, what's next for us?
Why don't you return to reality? I have a restaurant to run.
I guess I'll just stay here. Alone. Time doesn't exist here anyway, so who cares, right?
Agno! Okay. I'll be back in months' time.
You will.
Yep. Can I ask you something, Dave?
Shoot, old sport.
When I return, don't you have a plan for us? God knows how many souls are trapped here. You think you can figure out a way for us to free more of them?
I sure can, Sportsy. Leave it to me. I'll know exactly what to do by the time you get back.
Thank you, Dave. That's very useful.
That's me. Useful Dave.
Okay. It's been fun, Dave. Catch you next month.
Why, Sportsy. Good luck running your new Freddy's joint.
Thanks. Bye, Dave. And that was the first day, which took, like, a while. Yes. Okay. In fact, how long did that take? An hour? And I'm tired. So listen to tape and then it today episode.
Why, hello there. Welcome back to the Start Your Own Freddy Vamp and his Pizza Kit 1993 edition.
Actually, wait,
you've launched your own Edie Polka pizza joint and you have somehow gotten in time month without turning it down.
Bye.